Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Johnson. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Monday, the 19th of April. India continues to report over 200,000 daily COVID-19 cases. Capital New Delhi announces 6-day lockdown. President Ghani says Afghanistan ready for coalition forces pull out. And Nepal decides to close educational institutes until May 14 as COVID-19 cases surge. And now for all the details. India on Monday reported 273,810 new coronavirus cases, the highest single-day spike so far since the pandemic broke out, and the highest ever single-day spike in COVID-related deaths with 1,625 fatalities. Amid the second and more deadly virus wave across India, authorities in capital New Delhi have also announced a 6-day lockdown to tackle the crisis. India on Monday reported 273,810 new COVID-19 cases and 1,619 people succumbed to the infection in the last 24 hours. The country's Maharashtra, Karnataka states and capital New Delhi saw the biggest single-day surge in the last 24 hours. Maharashtra logged 68,631 infections, Delhi reported 25,462 new cases, while Karnataka saw a spike of 19,067 cases. Delhi, after imposing a weekend curfew on Monday, announced a 6-day lockdown to tackle the crisis. Following the announcement, people in capital queued outside liquor shops to stock up while migrant workers rushed to interstate bus stands to return to their villages.
हम किसी भी हालत में दिल्ली को उस परिस्थिति में नहीं ले जाना चाहते जहां कॉरिडोर के अंदर पेशेंट्स पड़े हैं सड़कों पे लोग दम तोड़ रहे हैं आज सभी परिस्थितियों का जायजा लेने के बाद आपकी सरकार को ये लगता है कि दिल्ली में कुछ दिन के लिए लॉकडाउन लगाना ज़रूरी है तो आज रात को 10 बजे से अगले सोमवार को सुबह 5 बजे तक 6 दिन के लिए दिल्ली में लॉकडाउन लगाया जा रहा है
पे आप मार्केट में भी देख सकते हैं बहुत भीड़ है कोई प्रिकॉशन इतने अच्छे से ले नहीं पा रहा है तो मैं ये देखती हूँ कि गवर्नमेंट ने ये बहुत अच्छा एक डिसीजन लिया है ऑल्दो पिछली बारी की तरह एक सडन लॉकडाउन नहीं उठा लिया
अमिड द सेकंड एंड मोर डेडली वायरस वेव अक्रॉस इंडिया द कंट्रीज हॉस्पिटल्स आर स्ट्रगलिंग विद अ शॉर्टेज ऑफ बेड्स ऑक्सीजन एंड की मेडिसिन दिस कम्स एज इंडिया इज अटेम्प्टिंग टू कंटिन्यू वैक्सीनेटिंग इट्स फ्रंटलाइन वर्कर्स एंड सिटीजंस over the age of 45. The country has so far administered over 122 million COVID vaccine doses. In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid on Monday informed that 11 policemen who were taken hostage in Lahore have been released following talks with the proscribed Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan. The far-right Islamist party was banned last Thursday following violent clashes over the arrest of their leader who had threatened to hold massive rallies against the cartoon depictions of Islam's prophet in France.
Pakistan's Interior Minister Sheikh Rashid in the early hours of Monday announced that after the first round of talks with the recently proscribed Tehreek-e-Labbaik Pakistan or TLP, 11 policemen who were taken hostage in Lahore have been released. After a week of violent clashes following the arrest of the TLP's leader Saad Hussain Rizvi, fresh clashes erupted on Sunday after protesters attacked the police station and took policemen as hostages. Pakistan's government had last week banned the far-right radical party TLP under anti-terrorism laws. After 3 days of violent clashes, as thousands of Islamists took to the streets demanding release of Rizvi, who was arrested for threatening to launch rallies to demand the expulsion of the French envoy from the country over the publication in France of depictions of Islam's prophet, which is considered blasphemous.
Aur pehla daur kafi behtri se mukammal hua hai. सैरी के बाद सुबह दूसरा राउंड होगा. उन्होंने गिरफ्तार जो बंदे ये गमारी बनाए थे पुलिस वाले 11 वो छोड़ दिए हैं और वो खुद भी टीएलपी के लोग मस्जिद रहमतुल आलमीन के अंदर चले गए हैं और पुलिस भी पीछे हट चुकी है.
The interior minister expressed hope that the rest of the matters would be resolved with the TLP in the next round of talks. TLP spokesperson Shafiq Amini said 4 supporters had been killed on Sunday in the violence. More than 300 police personnel have been injured and at least 4 policemen killed so far in the clashes since last week.
Moving on, Sindhi activists across the globe have been raising their voices against atrocities, human rights violations by the Pakistani establishment on its people and other minorities in the country. Several US-based Sindhi activists are on an almost month-long arduous journey from the UN headquarters in New York to Washington, D.C. to highlight human rights violations in Sindh province of Pakistan. Several US-based Sindhi activists are on an almost month-long arduous journey from New York outside the United Nations headquarters to Washington, D.C. to highlight human rights violations in Sindh province in Pakistan. The march, which began on April 7, is being organized by Sindhi Foundation spearheaded by US-based Sindhi activist Munawar Sufi Lagari. Titled Long Walk for Freedom, Nature and Love is a demonstration that will cut through 5 US states. Along the way, participants meet community members, other human rights groups and even political leaders who wish to support the fight against climate change in Sindh province and human rights violations.
We saw a significant increase in human rights violations and abuses during COVID in Sindh. We cannot just sit and watch while our loved ones get killed, abducted, and disappeared. Our innocent Sindhi Hindu girls are abducted. Most of them are underaged, and they are forcibly converted to Islam.
Issues such as enforced disappearances, the plight of Sindhi women in Pakistan, environmental problems in Sindh, and even something as basic as water has been some of the major concerns for the people of Sindh for decades. And countless voices seemingly fall on the deaf ears of those who could bring change. Moving on to news from Afghanistan. U.S. President Joe Biden last week announced end of U.S. troop deployment to Afghanistan, saying it is time for American troops to return home. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has now said that the country has long been ready for the US and NATO-led coalition forces withdrawal, while reiterating that his government is committed to the peace talks with the Taliban and that it is now up to the latter to act on it.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Sunday said that his country has long been ready for the US and NATO-led coalition forces withdrawal. This came days after US President Joe Biden announced all its troops will be out of Afghanistan by September 11, the 20th anniversary of the Al-Qaeda attacks that triggered America's longest war. During a security personnel medal awarding ceremony held in capital Kabul, he pointed out that the withdrawal of foreign forces from Afghanistan will require that Pakistan make a decision about whether to opt for cooperation or enmity with its neighbor. Ghani reiterated that Afghan government is committed to the peace talks with the Taliban and that it is now up to the latter to act on it. Meanwhile, facing pressure from Afghanistan's allies to participate in the upcoming Turkey conference, the Taliban said it will not attend any event, including the Istanbul summit, unless there is a change in the timeline for the withdrawal of US forces from the country. The meeting scheduled to be held on April 24 would include the United Nations and Qatar as part of a US-backed push to advance stalled Doha talks ahead of May 1 deadline for the withdrawal of foreign troops from Afghanistan. Biden's decision would miss a May 1 deadline for withdrawal agreed with Taliban insurgents by its predecessor Donald Trump's administration.
Modern news from Afghanistan. A drug treatment center in Afghanistan's Herat province is treating its patients through a unique idea of playing music and arranging parties for them twice a week. According to the recovered patients who now play music at the Jagra Treatment Center for others, the tune of music and melodies in the treatment center has inspired them to forget smoking, drugs.
A drug treatment center in Afghanistan's Herat province is treating its patients through a unique idea of playing music and arranging parties. According to the recovered patients who now play music at the Jagara Treatment Center, the tune of music and melodies in the treatment center has inspired them to forget smoking drugs. Although there are no official statistics on the number of drug addicts in Afghanistan, more than 3 million out of the country's some 32.5 million population have reportedly been addicted, including many in capital of Kabul. The Jagara Treatment Center in Herat province, since its establishment 8 years ago, has treated hundreds of patients.
In news from Nepal, the Nepal government on Monday announced the closure of all educational institutions in urban areas till May 14 in the wake of rising COVID-19 cases. Other services which bring about more people at one place have also been asked to close down.
An emergency ministerial meeting of the Nepal's cabinet on Monday decided to close all the educational institutions in urban areas till May 14, in the wake of rising COVID-19 cases. Prabhu Sah, a sitting minister in cabinet of Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli, while informing the ministerial meeting's decision, said other services which bring on more people at one place have also been asked to close. However, the government has directed schools and colleges to continue with their virtual classes. As of Monday, the Himalayan nation reported a total of 283,658 confirmed cases of coronavirus, with 3,075 deaths so far. The health ministry had on April 15 classified 14 districts including Kathmandu, Lalitpur and Bhaktapur as districts with high risk of COVID-19 and urged the people to follow safety protocols.
Moving on to news from Bhutan. The Himalayan nation of Bhutan was the first neighboring country to receive 150,000 doses of the AstraZeneca coronavirus vaccine from India in January. Today, Bhutan's vaccination drive is being considered a global success. Most people living in even remotest area of the isolated Himalayan kingdom have already received a coronavirus vaccine, as some villages were reached by helicopter and health workers hiked through ice and snow. The vast majority of Bhutan's first doses were administered at about 1,200 vaccination centers over a week-long period in late March and early April. According to Bhutan's health minister, 478,533 people have been inoculated, which is more than 60% of its population. More than 93% of eligible adults have received their first shots this month. The government has said it plans to administer second doses about 8 to 12 weeks after the first round, in line with the guidelines for the AstraZeneca vaccine. Bhutan has so far reported 957 confirmed coronavirus cases, with one death and 878 recoveries. Clay or earthen pots are commonly used, especially in villages and smaller cities of India, to store water during summers. However, with restricted movement of people due to rising coronavirus cases, potters in parts of the country are suffering losses in the absence of buyers from the market. They feared if lockdown is imposed, it will further create financial problems.
Potters in Dibrugarh in India's northeastern Assam state are suffering losses in the absence of buyers from the market amid rising coronavirus cases. Clay or earthen pots are common in Indian households, especially in villages and smaller cities, and are used to store water during summers as they help in keeping the water cool. However, with restricted movement of people and virus fears, potters said their products are not getting any takers. Fear of lockdown also gripped the public associated with the pottery industry. The nationwide coronavirus lockdown last year left millions of Indians living on the fringes of the economy with no work and some even without shelter and food.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/asianewsline and follow us on Twitter @asianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.